नो
व्हाट वाज दैट कुसुमा जी?
सर्वेशम नमो नमः। सॉरी आई एम लेट बाय अ फ्यू मिनट्स।
ओ दैट इज नवीन जी, सो दैट मस्ट बी तेलुगु देन। इज इट तेलुगु फॉन्ट्स नवीन जी?
आम आम आचार्य जी, आम आचार्य भगवान।
ओके, एंड आई वाज वंडरिंग इफ दैट वाज गीता जीज राइटिंग। ऑल राइट। मम नाम अंशु, भवत्याः नाम किम्? कृष्णवेणी जी।
मम नाम कृष्णवेणी, भवत्या नाम किं? नवीनना।
मम नाम
नाउ यू हैव टू से इट अगेन कृष्णवेणी जी।
कृष्णवेणी, भवत्या नाम किं? नवीनना।
वंस मोर। Do you know why am I asking you?
भवत्याः,
When you ask Naveen ji, भवतः नाम।
I'm sorry। भवतः नाम किं नवीन?
धन्यवादः। मम नाम नवीनः। This question is for कुसुमा महोदय। भवत्याः नाम किम्?
तव नाम किं महोदय?
You have to say that again. We have a breaking voice for Kusuma ji.
मम नाम कुसुमा, तव नाम किं महोदय?
And who are you asking?
I'm asking
Hemant Mahode, Hemant's mic is not working probably. Okay, Kusuma ji, can you ask somebody else? Okay, let me ask. I think the mic had some problem there. So let me ask. मम नाम अंशु, भवतः नाम किं? संजीव महोदय।
मम नाम संजीव आचार्य महोदय। भवत्याः नाम किं? दिस इज फॉर वर्षा महोदय। भवत्याः नाम किं?
मम नाम वर्षा। भवत्याः नाम किं मोहा महोदय?
मम नाम मोहा। भवतः नाम किं सुनील महोदय?
मम नाम सुनील। भवतः नाम किं महेश जी?
मम नाम महेशः। भवत्याः नाम किं कृष्णवेणी जी?
कृष्णवेणी, भवत्याः नाम किं गीता महोदय?
मम नाम गीता, भवतः नाम किं महेश महोदय?
मम नाम महेशः। भवतः नाम किं एस एस महोदय? Who is that?
Yes, mama naam Geeta.
Okay. I thought it was somebody else. Sorry for that. Okay. Mama naam Mahesh ha. Bhavatah naam kim Naveen Mahoday?
Mama naam Naveen ha. This question is for Moha Mahodaya. Bhavatyah naam kim?
Mama naam Moha. Bhavatah Acharya Mahoday Kaksha Arambh.
Kaksha Aramb Kuru. So when you want me to start the class, then you will say Kaksha Aramb Kuru.
I have one doubt.
Yes.
Bhavataha can be replaced with Kutava. That's what you have written.
Bhavataha can be?
Can it be replaced with tava?
Oh yes, we can use tava with, see, tava is an informal way of saying. So it's like tu or tum, people with either the same age or younger than you. You can say, yeah. You can use tava, but bhavatah is with always respect. So it is safer to use bhavatah all the time when you are not sure of the age and So bhavatah.
You have written bhavatah is for female, bhavatah is for male. Am I right?
Yes, bhavatah for males, okay. Bhavatyaha for females.
Okay.
All right, so now let us do a minute of Aum before we proceed, and then we will proceed. So I am going to unmute everyone. You don't have to manually do it. I have unmuted all of you. So similar to how Kusuma ji has also taught in her class when we do and that you see written here on the top of the page as well, need to have about equal timing. So we have practiced it a few times earlier also. So if your breath exhalation is about 3 seconds, so then just make sure you do 3 seconds for each. If you have 2 seconds, do 2 seconds for each. If you have 4 seconds, even better. All right, so now let us start together and we'll go for a minute, which is about 10 times of Aum, about 8 to 10 times. All right, so 1, 2, 3. Okay, hang on. Just hang on. Let us switch the method. I will say Aum and then you will go behind me. Then I will say next Aum, then you will go behind me. So that way it will be easily paced. All right, so let us try that first. You will start your Aum when I am done with my So once my Mo is done, then start. So that way you will be all in sync together.
Yeah.
Let's try once more. Stop now. Are you also closing your eyes when you say Aum?
Acharya Mahoday.
Acharya.
All right. So when you do it in silence and by yourself also, you might notice, as we discussed in the first class, that the A sound comes around your stomach. So it starts from around there. Then starts close to your chest, and the sound, the last one, is our Vishuddhi Chakra, which is the around the throat. So you can actually sense it. Where does it start? When you say in silence and in privacy, if you try with your eyes closed, it's easier to sense that. And so it's not an imagination, it is it really happens that way. All right, so now aham pathami sanskritam kim prathasi bhavatah Sunil Mahoday.
अहम पठामि संस्कृतम् पठसि मम महेश महोदय
मम पठामि संस्कृतम् भवत्याः किं पठसि मोहा महोदय
अहम
पठामि
वन्स मोर
अहं पठामि संस्कृतं भवत्याः किं पठसि मोहा महोदय
अहं पठामि एम आई राइट आचार्य महोदय
से दैट अगेन देयर वाज सम डिस्टरबेंस
अहं पठामि संस्कृतं
ये दस करेक्ट
अहम पठामी संस्कृतम
व्हाई वुड यू से पठामी इट इज पठामी
पठामी वाज टीचिंग राइट लर्निंग आई थॉट यू आर सेइंग आई एम टीचिंग संस्कृत एंड आई एम सेइंग आई एम लर्निंग संस्कृत दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज अस्यूमिंग
Correct. So pathami is learning or reading.
And teaching?
Oh, teaching would be related to a path verb, but right now I am not covering that. So just hold on.
Because I thought you were saying I am teaching Sanskrit. That is what I was. So that's the reason I said pathami. Not okay. Pathasi.
No, no. So I am a part of your group. Do not worry of me as a shikshak right now. So I am also saying aham pathami sanskritam, which means I am also learning Sanskrit. And kim pathasi bhavatyaha bhuhaji. What was that?
What's the difference between pathasi and pathami?
Pathasi. Pathasi is without the a matra. So pathasi is used with you, tvam, or whenever you are using it for somebody in front of you. And pathami is always used with aham. So it is an I verb. Whenever you are mentioning I am doing something, and then pathami, likhami, gachami, dhavami.
Can you repeat it, Acharya Mahadeva? Acharya Mahadeva, I didn't understand.
So whenever you use you use pathami with aham, right? Whenever you are using statements with I am doing something. So aham pathami, aham likhami. So ami always comes with a verb whenever you are using first person. So in English that is first person. You can say I. Verbs used with I. And when you use the verb with you, which is either tvam or bhavatah bhavatyah, then you will have to use pathasi or likhasi. So whenever you use a si at the end of the verb, then it means you are talking to, I am talking to you, or you are talking to another you in front of you somewhere.
You're talking to someone else.
Someone else in front of you. So I will not say sah pathami or sah pathasi. Sah means he or she, right? And which he or she could be in front of you, but not right in front of you. See, I am addressing you as you in English, but in English when I say he or she is not a you, right? Do you understand the difference between you versus she or he?
Right.
Correct. So sah or sa is she or he. So with those you cannot use either pathasi or pathami, because pathami is for I, pathasi is for you. So when you say sah, then with sah or sa you will have to use, and I think we have covered it or not yet. Oh, we haven't done it yet. So let me open a fresh page then, and let us do it right now. Here, okay. So with aham, aham pathami. All right, I am learning. Tvam.
I think we have done this. Like ashvah dhavati, when we said ti is used with third person, right?
We did use it, but it looks like few people remember it. So let's just cover it together so that you see the difference. So sah or sa pathati, similar to ashvah dhavati that we have used last time also. So now do you see the difference? With I, you will always use pathami or likhami, or with you, you will always use pathasi, likhasi, and with he or she, it is pathati or likhati. So notice the difference?
Yeah.
So only with pathami you have the a sound with the th. Others do not have that sound. It is pathasi, not pathasi. Does that help, my Moaji?
Trying to understand, Acharya Mahoday.
Okay, what happened? Is it still not
slightly confused?
So, is it like first person, second person, and third person, right?
Yes, same thing, exactly the same thing. That's why I have written I, you, and he or she. It is the same thing.
Maybe a sentence formation would help slowly. When I try to repeat the sentences, then I would get a better hang of it.
Okay, so aham pathami sanskritam. Kim pathasi tvam mahodaya?
Aham pathami sanskritam. Kim pathasi Kusuma Mahodaya?
Aham pathami sanskritam. Kim pathasi bhavatya?
Kusumaji, you might have to say that again. Who were you asking the question?
Krishna
Vini. Oh, Krishna Vini.
Bhavatyaha is for ladies.
Yeah, you're right. Bhavatyaha.
Aham padami sanskritam. Saha kim patati? Navinana.
Aham padami sanskritam.
Now, see, let Krishnaveni ji repeat her question, because that is an interesting question.
Okay, can you repeat your question? I thought maybe I heard it wrong. Yeah, say, can you repeat your question, Krishnaveni Mahodaya?
Saha kim patati?
Saha kim patati? That means, what is he learning, right? And who is he in this case? Myself.
Anybody. So
okay,
she is probably saying saha kim, let's say for Mahesh ji, she is asking saha kim pathati.
Mahesh Mahodaya Sanskritam Patati.
Okay, and now let me write a more relevant question which you can ask anybody without worrying about who are you asking. So, बालकः और बालिका
वा किम
पठति. सो नाउ दिस इज आल्सो अ थर्ड पर्सन, राइट? बालकः और बालिका, एंड यू कैन आस्क एनीबॉडी.
तव
महेश महोदय, तव बालकः किम पठति?
Balakah patati sanskritam.
Okay, so now when you answer, because I asked your son or your daughter, right?
Yeah.
Tava is yours. So then you start
mama.
With mama.
Mama balakah patati sanskritam.
Correct.
Patati, not patati, patati.
Yeah, correct. Mama balakah patati sanskritam.
Okay, pass it on. Pass it on to Moaji, because she is confused.
Okay. तव बालिका किं पठति मोहा महोदय
महोदय
मम बालक संस्कृत
बालकः
मम बालकः संस्कृत पठति
संस्कृतं पठति
मम बालक संस्कृतं पठति
वन्स मोर
मम बालक संस्कृतं पठति
वन्स मोर
मम बालकः संस्कृतं पठति
परफेक्ट ओके सिट ऑन But see, now I know that you don't have a son. So you can always say, Mama Balakaha na asti. So,
I wanted to say that.
See, so that is how you have fun in Sanskrit, right? So when you have realistic situations, maybe somebody is asking you, Tava Balakaha or Balika kim patati? And you don't have a son or a daughter. So you will say mama balaka or balika, whatever was the question, nasti.
Nasti.
Na dhan asti becomes nasti. Okay, go ahead, Moazi. Ask somebody else.
Tava balak kim pathasi?
Once more.
Shaji?
Once more.
Tava balak kim पठासी गीता महोदया
वंस मोर
कैन यू रिपीट महाकर
तव बालक किम पठति
यप सवश उत्तम
मम बालकः अनंत संस्कृतम पठति
परफेक्ट सो मोहाजी यू वर इनिशियली यू वर यूजिंग पठसि बट राइट सो
पठति
फॉर बालकः फॉर बालिका इट विल बी पठति राइट
आचार्य जी
या गीता महोदय वन सेकंड समबडी हैज अ क्वेश्चन संजीव
हां आचार्य जी
यस
आचार्य महोदय Instead of tava, we can use bhavatyaha also, right? Bhavataha and bhavatyaha.
Bhavataha or bhavatyaha, yes.
Okay.
So I'm asking a question now to Varsha Mahodaya. Bhavatyaha balakaha kim patati?
Mam balakaha nasti. So I would ask, whom do I ask? Acharya Mahodaya.
Okay.
Tava Balika Kim Pathati Acharya Mahodaya?
Mam Balika Nasti.
Balika.
परन्तु
मम बालकः संस्कृतं पठति सो यू कैन यूज परन्तु
फॉर परन्तु
फॉर अ बट और
बट राइट
हाउएवर सो बोथ आर द सेम यूसेज Okay, Tam, who is remaining, I think? Tava Balakah, Kim Pathati Mahesh Mahode?
मम बालकः नास्ति.
ओके
मम बालिका भी नास्ति.
ओके अपि
दैट्स अ सेफ आंसर.
सो इफ यू आल्सो वांट टू से मम बालकः नास्ति, मम बालिका अपि नास्ति. सो अपि इज आल्सो.
आल्सो ओके.
मम बालिका अपि नास्ति, बट अपि यू कैन यूज आफ्टर यू हैव ऑलरेडी सेड दैट मम बालकः नास्ति, बिकॉज़ दिस इज आल्सो. सो इट हैज टू प्रीसीड अनदर सेंटेंस व्हिच कवर्स समथिंग एल्स.
एंड वी कैन यूज च, राइट, टू ऐड और एंड.
च इज एंड. सो
यस
करेक्ट.
मम बालकः बालिका च नास्ति.
Oh, that way, yes, correct.
What about evam then? Can we use evam?
We can use, but now I am noticing in most Sanskrit texts, it uses cha more than evam. So,
evam?
I have to research now why evam is not used that much. So, I'll have to find out. Okay. Probably evam is more of Hindi than Sanskrit.
Cha means what, Acharya Mahoday?
Cha is for and. So and. If you want to say okay. Mama Balakah Balika
Cha Nasti.
So cha is used after the word before which you want to put an and. So this is a slightly tricky method. So you wanted to use and here, right? Mama balakah and balika naasti. Correct.
Balakah balika naasti. Okay.
Right. So cha will be used after the word where you wanted to use and. So mama balakah balika cha naasti.
And if I want to say I and someone, then where do you put cha?
At the end only, I think.
No, last day we learned something else.
We haven't used cha with I yet. Did we? I don't think we have used it.
Yes, you gave an example last day. I don't have it written.
Let's see.
Yeah, aham ashwah cha dhavato. It was me, I am horse, and then cha, that was.
Oh, that one. Aham ashwah cha dhavato, correct. You can see on my screen here.
So it is preceding another word, right, that we end with?
Cha is after the word before which you wanted to use an and. So you wanted to use an and before ashvaha, right? Aham and the ashvaha are running. So you use it after that word. So you mention the word first and then use cha right after it.
So in this way we can use multiple people or objects and then end it after that we can keep a cha so that all can be combined, right?
Yes, that is a slightly advanced usage and we will come there because Sanskrit also prefers to use smaller sentences. So you would normally want to reduce the size of your sentences.
Okay.
So that way you will want to say mama balikah naasti, mama balika api naasti. So both are separate sentences.
Okay.
Yes, I think Kusuma ji was saying something, or Gita ji.
Yes, Emma. I have a doubt. In you say Namo Rudraya, Bhavaya, Rudraya, Namaste, Rudraya. For every thing, for every word, there is cha cha cha. Now you mean it and. For every name of Shiva, cha is used before the next one. Is that the way it will go?
Could you repeat the initial shloka that you were mentioning? Mama Rudraya, what was that?
Namo Bhavaya cha Rudraya cha Sarvaya cha Kashkataya cha. Like that, it will go on. That's Samakam. It is called Samakam.
Okay. That way, we have this cha even here. You can see. So then this breaks the rules. Even in our Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva. So this cha should have been used here, ideally, if we follow the grammar of Sanskrit. But because this is prose, this is a shlok, that is why it takes the liberty of using cha here. Even with Tvameva Bandhush Cha Sakha Tvameva. So even this cha should have been after the Sakha. But this is allowed in poems. When you have songs, then the use of cha can shift here and there according to your matra. Not matra, but the song itself or the way you are saying it. But yes, what Kusuma ji also mentioned is useful, that whenever you are combining multiple things, you keep using cha with each. So you can say Ashvaha cha Ishvaraha
comma
Ishaha Ashvaha cha. But we will come to that when we come to an advanced usage of multiple items together, multiple people together. We'll see how cha is used there. But for now, hold on.
Acharyaji, maybe
let us practice what we are
like
on. What was that, Gita ji?
I was saying the cha is like fluid, like you can use it either before or after. So it is a kind of a fluid letter. You can use it anyway.
Fluid in some senses. So for example, this Tvameva Mata Cha Pita Tvameva has used cha very differently compared to the grammatical Sanskrit. So we can say it is fluid in some senses, but we'll learn more about it as we go along. As the usage arises, then we will learn about it.
Okay, Acharya. Thank you.
So what we are trying to do right now is learn what we need to communicate immediately. So when I want to say Mama Balika Balika Cha Nasti, so then I know that where to use the cha. But in this case, I will not be saying Mama Balika Balika and there is nothing else, because I can either have a son or a daughter, nothing else. So there is no need of another combination yet. But when the need arises, we'll learn about it. Okay, so Ashwaha, with Ashwaha we had learnt about
Acharya, I have a question. Dhavato, about Dhavato.
Yes.
When do we use Dhavato?
With two.
Ami, I understand. When Dhavato? Dhavati and Dhavami is okay.
Continuous tense.
Till now, with Dhavati or Dhavami, we were learning all single person, right? This is always one person. This is Ekvachan.
Okay, yeah. Aham and Ashwaha, two things are there, and that is why Dhavato.
So even with saha or sa, it is ekvachan. It is either he or she. But if it is he and she, then you will use saha, sa. Because but with saha and sa you cannot use very easily. But dhavatav is for dvivachan.
Got it.
When there are two people.
What is used for they, Acharyaji? They are those.
Okay. Let us go there. Just a second. Let me also tell you what will you use with. If there were many horses. So where should we write it? We had an empty page here. Where is my empty page? Okay, let me try here. So Ashwaha. Dhavanti. So if there are many horses. So Dhavanti is are running. So similarly, if you wanted to say horses are studying, so then you would say Ashwaha Pathanti.
They do study our emotions.
Patanti Ashwaha.
Yes, but we can always say Sarvesham Patanti. So all of you are studying. This is actually a correct usage, but yes, with Ashwaha also, if you want to say Patanti, it is okay. In Panchatantra, you will always find such. Okay, everybody is in. Let me check.
Bhavatah screen pashyami.
Javanika.
Javanika.
Acharya Mahode, I have one doubt. Yes. When you read the tortoise about the tava, balakaha, balika, kim patati, the answer was mama balakaha. Samskrutam patati. So the patati in question and question, patati in answer both remain the same when it comes to third person. Correct?
Exactly. Because you are always talking about the third person either in the question or the answer.
So the patati will remain same, constant. Correct?
Yes.
Yeah.
But when I am asking you, what are you studying? So when I am asking, I have to use patasi because I am saying you. But when you answer, you have to say aham pathami. So then it has to become pathami.
Pathami.
Because your subject is changing. But in he or she, subject is not changing. It is always he. I am asking he and you are also answering he or she. So then that is why pathati remains the same.
But both of them. Because balakaha, balika. Both the genders being different, but patati will be the same. Correct?
That is same for even. See, when you are answering aham pathami, you do not consider whether you are a girl or a boy, right? Aham pathami is aham pathami.
Correct.
And even when asking this question, kim pathasi bhavatah or kim pathasi bhavatyah. So, this bhavatah or bhavatyah change, but the verb does not change. Verb is always the same.
Correct. Yes. Right? The kriya. Now I understood.
Correct. The kriya does not have a gender. What happened? Were you trying to read something?
Sarvesha, I was writing that the Ashwaha Dhavanti. I was writing Patanti. If horses are running,
one second. Okay. Sarvesham Pathanti, which means everybody is studying.
And what do we say for everyone can see your screen? Sarvesham Pashyanti Kavyavanika.
We have used it before. Mama Yavanika Pashyatu Va. So I am simply asking, is my screen, are you seeing my screen?
If we all have to say yes, we all can see your screen then.
So now you will be using another construct. So let me just hold on that question, because I think Mahesh asked another question before. So let us cover that first.
Yeah, no.
Saha Tau Te. So Saha Pathati Tau Pathatau. This is two people. So when you want to say those two are reading or those two are studying, then you will say Tau Pathatau and Te Puthanti. So this is for they, plural. Tau means Dvivachan.
Astu.
This is Bahuvachan. Which means anything more than two. So for two, Sanskrit has a very specific construct which not many other languages have. Other languages would have either just he and she or they. So they covers everything else, but Sanskrit has a very specific usage for two people or two horses, two of anything.
Yeah.
So Maheshji, does that help?
Ama Acharya.
Acharya ji, Saha is for he, Sa is for she, no?
Correct. So Sa or Sah. Sa is for she, Sah is for he. Correct. Sa Patati or Sah Patati. Okay, so now let us go to the Vibhaktis. Vibhakti, somebody was asking last time, I think it was Naveen Mahoday. Did you understand this? Did you understand this or you want to repeat it?
Repeat it, Acharya Mahoday. The video, I was going through the video, this part especially got
missed out.
It was not able to record because you had a disconnect in the WebEx session and then the recording was not done.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, recording started probably a little late. So just remember, if any of you can remind me whenever we have either disconnects or even at the starting, just remind me that if we are recording, so that sometimes I might forget to start it, so that way our video will not miss things. Okay, so Vibhakti means what kind of articles do we use for each word. So in this case, Ramah or Vrikshah, Ramah is a akarant pulling shabd, which means it ends in a. And so Ram, when you say Ram, so that end of the word is a. So I can show you a different word. For example, Nadi. Nadi is a ikarant striling shabd because it ends in e, and it is a striling shabd. So similarly, Ram is a
pulling shabd.
Akarant pulling shabd. Okay.
Akarant pulling shabd.
And okay. Why am I saying this akarant ikarant? Because the way a word ends at the end of the word, the vibhakti, there are different forms of vibhaktis. So that is why I am not going to confuse you right now with all the vibhaktis. Let us learn one by one. So first we will learn akarant pulling shabd vibhakti, how they run. And once we get used to it, then we will learn about how Nadi or Ravi, those words, how do they have their own different forms of usage later on. So with Ram, there are, with every word, there are always eight vibhaktis. Prathama, Dvitiya, Tritiya, Chaturthi, Panchami, Shashti, Saptami and Ashtami. Now, Prathama is for when Ram did something. So when you want to say Ramah Patati. So Ram is studying, Ram is doing something, right? So we use a simple Ramah. That is the Prathama, the most common usage. Now Dvitiya is to Ram. So you did something to Ram. So Ram ko. So that is Ramam.
Ramam.
So the way to remember vibhaktis is you can read this column, the first column directly. So this is how people try to remember. Ramah, Ramam, Ramen. Ramay, Ramat, Ramasya. Rame, He Ram.
Okay. So are we going to give examples, udaharan for each of these vibhaktis?
Not right now, but we have used one of them last time, which was that, let me see.
Sanskritasya.
Did we use that?
Yes, Sanskritasya. Yes.
I'm just trying to find that page where we used it. Okay, here. Etat Sanskritasya Pustakam. So now let me go back to the Vibhakti page first, and I will show you the different Vibhaktis, and then we figure out why we used Sanskritasya. Because this Ramasya or Sanskritasya, both are Akarant Pulling Shabd, and Shashti is for off or ka ke ki. So Sanskritasya means off Sanskrit. So we wanted to say the Pustakam is a Sanskrit book. So that is why we said Sanskritasya Pustakam.
So when you say Sanskritasya Sada Bhakto, that means I am a devotee of Sanskrit, right?
Yes, I am a devotee of Sanskrit, correct.
Okay.
That is a good example. Let us write it with the same thing. In some space. Okay. What was that?
Samskritasya Sada Bhakto.
Bhakto.
Bhakto. Okay.
Is it Bhaktau, Naveen Mohade?
Bhakto. It is Bhakto. Yeah. I got this from my Mama Balika, they
are also studying.
Patati Sanskritam in the summer. So Sanskrita Bharati, they learned it from Sanskrita Bharati, and before every class they have a pledge. They have a pledge like a poem.
Oh, nice.
So yeah, so I will send that to you, Acharya Mahoday, if we can also say that pledge before the class. I think that would be helpful.
Yeah, that will be nice. Just send me across.
Okay, you go through it and let us know.
Yeah, and this one we can also.
I was going to ask you, is there any kind of a poem with Rama, something like that, which they teach in school? Because I remember having learned in one of the classes when way back, I'm talking about 35 years back.
I have seen a
Rama, right?
Is this the Vibhakti which they tell? I forgot actually.
No, I have seen a poem which includes Ram in one of the Swami Vivekanand magazines. If you have heard of Vivek Jyoti, that comes from Ramakrishna Ashram. So in the last month, there was a shlok which includes all the Vibhaktis of the Ram Shabd. So that was a nice one to remember it. But it does not go with grammatical rules. So that was a problem with that shlok. So that is why I haven't covered it yet. But now that you have mentioned it, I can bring it in the class just out of interest.
Okay, let's finish covering this, right?
So Ramam is Dvitiya, which means to Ram. Then Ramel is Tritiya, which means through Ram or from Ram. Ramaya is Chaturthi, which is for Ram. Then Ramat is Panchami, which is by Ram. And usually this is a separation. So when you want to say Vrakshat Phalam Patati. So from the tree, fruit is falling down or a fruit is separating. So then Panchami is used, because you might see that Tritiya and Panchami look similar in terms of this from or right. So they have a slightly different usage when things separate or from the subject. Then you will use Ramat or Vrikshat. Otherwise, when you want to use by or from, then you will use Ramena. Then Ramasya or Sanskritasya, we already tried Sanskritasya Pustakam, which is of Ram or of Sanskrit. Saptami is Rame or Vrikshe, depending on whichever word you are using. Rame means in or on. That is the usage. That is when you will use Rame or Vrikshe. And finally, it is Sambodhan, Hey Ram. So this is the simplest Vibhakti, Hey Ram or Hey Vrikshe. This is for respect, paying respect to someone. So we will pick sentences for each word. I think today's time is crossed, so we will stop now. Let me see. If you have any questions, please mention a question, and once we are done, then we'll stop. Yesterday we went on for quite a long time because we had a long interruption in the starting itself. So, but today we could have a full class properly. So, any questions? Sarvesham prasnaha kurvantu.
Na acharya.
Grihakarya.
Okay, Grihakarya. So that is a good one. Do write Vriksha all the vibhaktis of the shabd vriksha and sanskrita.
Vriksha we already did in last class. Vriksha, vriksham, vrikshrein, vrikshai, vrikshat, vrikshas.
Did you do it?
That.
Okay. Then do it for Sanskrit. And I am still, I am yet to review some of your assignment submissions. I think from starting from Sanjeev Ji's submission that is pending. I was listening to it, and because tomorrow is Raksha Bandhan, so there are other programs also going on. So, but I will review those which you have submitted on the group. I think I have reviewed Varsha ji's, Moha ji's and Naveen Mahoday's submissions, right?
So you've not reviewed mine, I think.
Correct. So starting from Sanjeev ji's submission, it is pending. So I think that covers yours also. So I'll do that. And all right then. Sarvesham Namo Namaha Subharatri.
Sarvesham Namo Namaha Dhanyavadha.
Sarvesham Namo Namaha Subharatri.
Thank you.
Sarvesham Namo Namaha Subharatri.